Bobby Smith, number 22, Stacey White, number 20, Hayley Heald, number 3, Jess Corker, number 19, Joe Olenshaw, and number 24, Emma Hartley. Your Featherstone team for today, at number 1, Hayley Baldwin, right wing, number 2, Sarah Dunn, number 3, Rhiannon Marshall, number 4, Kay Haley. Number 5, Melina Spur. Number 6, Andrea Dobson. Number 7, Georgia Roche. Number 8, Anna Small. Number 9, Sinead Pope. Number 10, Zoe Treese. Number 11, Jazz Hazel. Number 12, Jazz Bell. Number 13, Grace Field. And on the interchange bench, number 40, Erica Jane, number 15, Megan Price, and number 16, Madison Roderick.
There you go. Good afternoon and welcome to the inaugural Women's Super League Grand Final. Bradford Bulls and Featherstone Rovers meeting in the first ever Women's Super League Grand Final this afternoon at the Manchester Regional Arena. And it's a showpiece event to end a fantastic season for both Bradford and Featherstone. For the Bradford Bulls, it has been an absolutely outstanding year as they arrive at the Manchester Regional Arena this afternoon, undefeated. 11 games, 11 wins, and they will be looking to make sure that there will be no complacency today against the Featherstone Rovers side, who produced one of the biggest shocks of the season when they beat Fatohef St Helens in Golden Point extra time, booking their place in this afternoon's inaugural Women's Super League Grand Final. Well, we're just waiting for the two sides to emerge, and they're going to be led side by side by the match officials. And today's meeting between Bradford and Featherstone, it'll be the fourth time the West Yorkshire rivals have met in 2017, with Bradford comprehensively beating Featherstone on all three previous occasions. They met in the Challenge Cup final at York in July. They met 2 weeks later at Post Office Road, Bradford winning that one by 24 points to nil. And then just 13 days ago, in the final round of the Women's Super League season at the Providence Stadium, Oddsall, Bradford winning by 72 points to 10. The profile of the women's game has risen over the last 12 months. In for a real rugby league treat this lunchtime. Well, the two sides have just emerged from the tunnel directly to our left, so we'll start with the Bradford Bulls in the red, amber and black. The head coach is Mark Prescott. Fullback Charlotte Booth. Wing three quarter line of Charlene Hennigan, Savannah Andrade, Amy Hardcastle and Lisa Taylor. In the halves, Claire Gardner and Kirsty Maroney. The front row forwards, Lauren Hickey, Stacey Wilson and Beth Sutcliffe. The back rowers, Shona Hoyle, Amy Staveley and Lewis Fussell. On the interchange bench for the Bradford Bulls this afternoon, Danny Swain, Debbie Smith, Stacey White, Hayley Hildes, Jess Cortman, Joe Orlenshaw and Emma Hartley. Featherstone Rovers, fresh after that Golden Point extra time victory against Fatohef St Helens last week, have Kayleigh Bullman at fullback. Winfrey quarterline, Shara Dunn, Rhiannon Marshall, Casey Haley and Menina Spurs. The halfback pairing for Featherstone Rovers this afternoon, Andrea Dobson and Georgia Roach. The front row forwards, Emma Sloan and Zoe Teach. The hooker, Sinead Peach. And the back row forwards of Jazz Hazel, Jazz Bell and Grace Field, binding the pack at loose forward. And on the interchange bench this afternoon for Featherstone Rovers, Erica Zania, Megan Price and Madison Lawrence. Two players then, we'll pick one from each. That really could be eye catchers this afternoon. We've gone for Rhiannon Marshall in the Featherstone Rovers side. Started the season with the Bradford Bulls, incidentally, before not getting any game time under head coach Mark Prescott. She now lines up in the inaugural Women's Super League Grand Final against her former teammates. So Rhiannon Marshall, impressive character both on and off the field, very grounded. She's bound by that natural enthusiasm to succeed, and she will have a big presence out wide on the edge for Featherstone this afternoon. For the Bradford Bulls then, it's the skipper, Kirsty Maroney, again another huge character, equally huge impact to match both on and off the field. Excellent runner with ball in hand, also shows up in defence when it's needed, and certainly offers much needed foundation and is a superb organiser. Kirsty Maroney, of course, one of numerous England internationals in both sides this afternoon. So the Women's Rugby League Super League table. Bradford Bulls finished top of the pile, undefeated. Fatuhi St. Helens finished second, closely behind the Bradford Bulls. Featherstone finished third, and Castleford finished fourth in the table. As we said, Bradford's results to the final, big wins on the road, Castleford, Fatuhi St. Helens, and of course Featherstone. And if you take into account the previous 11 games, including those early Challenge Cup ties, Bradford currently posting an average score of 53 points to 9. That's the task facing Featherstone Rovers this afternoon, but they went to Fatuhi St. Helens last Sunday and in Golden Point extra time came away with an historic and memorable 21-20 victory. Well, the Bradford skipper Kirsty Moroney speaking to her before the game, very grounded in saying that the previous games don't matter. Featherstone will make it tough for us. We know they will turn up and give us a game this afternoon. Well, Featherstone skipper Natalie Harrowell, she felt that they have the winning formula to beat Bradford if they start well, and then the confidence will grow and anything can happen on grand final day. So we're about to get proceedings underway here at the Manchester Regional Arena. Let's have some fun. And it is going to be Kirsty Moroney to get proceedings underway. And the first tackle driving the ball in is going to be the big prop forward, Emma Sloan. And Emma Sloan under pressure there from Lauren Hickey. And Lewis Fussell has come up with the first error of the match. And it's going to be a scrum feed, head and feet to the Bradford Bulls, 20 metres out from that Featherstone Rovers try line. So Bradford, an early opportunity here. We've had 30 seconds gone on the clock. It's going to be Moroney to feed the scrum, and it's taken out by Booth. Booth, one of 10 England internationals in this Bradford side, is brought down, 10 out, just to the left-hand side of those uprights. Bradford with an early chance here as it goes down the middle with Hickey. Hickey gets the legs driving forward. There's two women in the mark of defence. Featherstone backed up on their own try line. Out of dummy half from Fussell. Fussell to Andre, to Garner. And Garner now is going to be brought down on tackle number three for the Bulls. Fussell out of dummy half, tries to muscle a way over, but Bullman and Dunn there, great defence, early doors from Featherstone, and there's going to be an early try here for the Bradford Bulls. Moroney picks it up from dummy half, and Kirsty Moroney, captain fantastic for the Bradford Bulls, gets the opening score in the 2017 Women's Super League Grand Final, and it's 4-0 to the Bradford Bulls. Barely 2 minutes on the clock.
On the ball today, Bradford Bulls.
And that'll give the travelling army that have come over, the Pennines from the Providence Stadium, also Kirsty Moroney is picking the ball up at dummy half, realising there was a gap between the mark and defence, and she's touched down 10 metres to the left-hand side of the uprights. And Claire Garner now has an opportunity to add on the extra two, which she does, and it is an extra 2 points to the Bradford Bulls. And with 3 minutes gone on the clock, it is the Bradford Bulls 6, Featherstone Rovers 0. Still coaches arriving in the car park behind our commentary position. There'll be a big crowd once everybody's inside, but it's great to see the rugby league community supporting this inaugural Women's Super League Grand Final here in Manchester. So from the restart, Andre takes it right up to around about the 10. Three-man tackle led by Hazel, Bell and Field for Featherstone. And Bradford now have got a bit of work to do, carrying this ball out from their own goal line inside their own 20. So two tackles gone. Early try to the Bradford Bulls by Kirsty Moroney, converted by Claire Gardner. It is the Bradford Bulls 6, Featherstone Rovers 0, as it goes out towards Amy Hardcastle, who's brought down in a two-man tackle, 10 shy of the halfway line, just to the left of centre field. Here goes Fussell. She misses out Hickey. And it is going to be Moroni who takes the tackle on tackle number four, just shy of the halfway line. So a good solid defensive step from Featherstone thus far, as Fassell once again trying to catch those markers, not square, but Hazel and Bell bring Fassell down on the fifth and last tackle. It's going to go out of dummy half from Moroni. It's Garner with ball in hand. Garner's going to kick towards the wing, trying to involve Andrade, but Andrade's missed it, and Featherstone pick it up with Dunn. But Sarah Dunn skirts with this main stand touchline, and she's been dragged into touch there by Hardcastle, and it is going to be a second error from Featherstone, and it's going to be a repeat set effectively to Bradford, 5 metres inside the Featherstone Rovers half. And that's got the Bradford Bull supporters over on the far stand side banging the drum and certainly blowing the trumpet. So Bradford, another opportunity. It is going to be Kirsty Moroni to feed this scrum. Out it goes. Here goes Beth Sutcliffe, another one of these Bradford Bulls England internationals, and she's brought down 35 out from that Featherstone try line in centre field. Here it goes now with Hardcastle. Hardcastle beats one, still driving forward. Good cover tackle there as Jazz Hazel had to come in and wrap Hardcastle up. They're 20 metres out, and it's going to be a penalty to Featherstone for an incorrect play of the ball, says the referee. Not playing the ball correctly, so an early penalty to Featherstone Rovers. Exactly 5 minutes gone on the clock. Well, as we said, previous meetings in 2017, this the fourth meeting. They first met in round three of the Super League, Featherstone Rovers 0, Bradford 24. They then met in that Challenge Cup final at York at Huath in front of a four-figure crowd, over 1,000 spectators there in July, as Bradford come from behind to win 50 points to 16. And then, as we said, 13 days previously, both these sides met at the Providence Stadium, also Bradford winning 72 points to 10. But Featherstone back off the canvas, although an error's just come out of dummy half. Peach's pass to Roach has been knocked on, and that'll be a zero tackle, and Bradford will have the ball just shy of the halfway line. Fassell gives it there to Hickey. Hickey has the legs driving forward. Two Featherstone Rovers defenders wrap her up, and she's brought down five in from this main stand side. So Fassell to Moroni. Moroni along the line to Hoyle, and Hoyle's going to be brought down 5 metres inside that Featherstone half. Featherstone defending in their purple and navy blue shirts. Fassell to Moroni. Moroni along the line there to Sutcliffe. Sutcliffe to Staveley. Staveley's just gone without the ball. Referee puts whistle to lips. He's going to say first knock on from the Bradford Bulls, and this will be scrum head and feed to Featherstone, just shy of the halfway line. So anyone just joining us on the Rugby Football League's live feed, we've just had just shy of 7 minutes played here, and it is the Bradford Bulls 6, Featherstone Rovers 0, after an early try from Kirsty Moroni. So from the scrum, Featherstone looking to build some momentum, get a bit of confidence back. Out of dummy half from Peach, the England international hooker, and she is going to slide the ball there to Sloan, and Sloan's inside the Bradford half on tackle number one. It's going to go once again from Peach. This is Field. Field takes out Wilson and Hoyle out of that Bradford Bulls defensive line, and she in turn is going to find the half back of Dobson. Dobson's going to keep the ball going to Bell, and Bell's going to be wrapped up 30 metres out from the Bradford Bulls try line, just to the right of centre field. Out of dummy half once again from Dobson to Roach. Roach trying to evolve Marshall, the former Bradford Bulls centre, over on the far stand side, and on the last tackle, the 20 out from the line, the go to the sky with Dobson. It's going to be allowed to bounce. It's come off a Bradford hand, and Featherstone are going to get a repeat set here. If the referee just looks towards the touch judge on this main stand side, the touch judge coming on, that looked to have come off a Bradford hand, and this looks like it could be head and feed to Featherstone, and more pressure for him. He is going to give the scrum to Featherstone, so Bradford are going to have some more defending to do. 10 out from their own try line. So Featherstone, as we said, building pressure. It is the inaugural Women's Super League Grand Final. How it goes from the scrum, it goes to Dobson. Dobson drops the shoulder, tries to pirouette away past the Bradford defence, but can't. And she's brought down five out from the line. Picked up by Peach. Peach gives it to Lawrence. Lawrence charging towards that Bradford Bulls try line. She's only metres away, and she's brought down on top of it. It'll be a quick play of the ball. Peach's options to her left, to her right. She goes to Dobson. Dobson sucks in the Bulls defence, gives it to Sloane. And Sloane is held up on top of the line. Peach to Dobson. Dobson to Roach. Roach is wrapped up. The two sevens, Moroni and Roach, collide. And that's the fourth tackle gone. Valiant defending from the Bulls. They're going to try and go out wide. It's come off a Bradford player, but it's gone backwards. And the referee is going to say Bradford will live to fight another day. And that was great play there, as Charlene Hennigan, she just palmed the ball, tipped it back towards her own line. The danger reverted, and the score still remains Bradford Bulls 6, Featherstone Rovers 0. We've had 9 minutes gone. Featherstone enjoying a lot of territorial pressure after that first error from the kickoff by Emma Sloane, which led to that Kirsty Moroni try. So Bradford just doing those hard yards forward, coming out of their own 20. Supporters still arriving inside the Manchester Regional Arena as it goes out to Moroni. Moroni linking there with Garner, and Garner's going to be brought down 20 out from her own try line. So a good solid defensive set from Featherstone Rovers. Referee says last tackle. They're in centre field, 20 out from their own line. They're going to go back to Claire Garner. Garner's going to kick it downfield, but it's gone straight into the arms of Spur, and Menina Spur's going to be flat and just shy of the halfway line there in a two-man tackle led by Amy Hardcastle and Lisa Taylor. Peach goes out of dummy half and gives it to Haley. Casey Haley gets to her feet. The five now inside the Bradford Bulls territory as it goes there to the black scrum cap wearing Joe Teach, and Teach is now brought down just 25 shy of the Bradford line as it now goes with Andrea Dobson striding forward, wrapped up, dumped on her back. Options now on tackle number four for Sinead Peach, the England hooker, although there's been a bit of a miscommunication there as Peach's pass to Roach has just been tipped forward. She had Kirsty Moroni coming in her eye line, in her vision, and it is the third error of the afternoon from Featherstone Rovers, but certainly a much improved last 5 minutes, it must be said. A lot of positives there as Bradford not having everything their own way, which they did 13 days ago at the Providence Stadium. Also, Kirsty Moroni then is going to feed the ball in the scrum. 30 out from their own try line as it goes along the line to Hardcastle. Hardcastle's wrapped up on tackle number one. In defence there for Featherstone was Bell and Field. Here goes Hickey driving in up to the halfway line, just to the left hand side for Sellers options. Bradford not really going through an expansive type of game that they've been accustomed to in 2017. Conditions dictating that. Light drizzle here as it goes down the middle with Amy Staveley on tackle number three. 40 away from the Featherstone line. Here goes Moroni. Moroni, an inside pass there to Sutcliffe, and Sutcliffe takes it up to the Featherstone 30. Tackle number four gone. One remaining in this set of six for the Bulls. It goes to Fussell. It goes to Moroni. Moroni's wrapped up in a three-man tackle, and this will be the fifth and last. 25 out from that Featherstone line. It's almost certainly going to go back to Garner, who will put boot to ball, which she does. It comes off a Featherstone player, but it goes backwards, and it's straight into the arms there of Casey Haley, and she'll take the first tackle here for Featherstone. Out of dummy half by Kayleigh Bowman, another England international, and she's brought down 30 out from her own try line, 20 shy of halfway. Fussell out of dummy half, twisting and turning, wrapped up in a two-man, two-woman cover tackle, and she's just brought down 15 shy of halfway. Here we go, down the middle once again with Jazz Bell. Jazz Bell trying to swap those Bradford Bulls defenders away, and she's brought down 10 shy. Traditional stuff here at the Manchester Regional Arena as it goes once again with Grace Field now getting involved. So Featherstone restricted to just 30 metres on this set of six by the Bradford Bulls defence as it goes out of dummy half from Sloane to Dobson, and Dobson is going to kick towards the far stand corner, and that is dealt there by Savannah Andrade, and she's going to take the tackle just shy of her own 30. So Bradford, they're going to have to come from deep. Featherstone doing a mountain of work in defence, keeping Bradford penned in here. Here goes Fussell, a hat-trick against Featherstone last time out in that 72-10 win, and she's brought down on the halfway line on tackle number three for the Bradford Bulls women's side. Fussell then to Garner. Garner gives it there to Staveley, and Staveley's going to be brought down 10 inside the Featherstone Rovers half as it goes from Fussell. Fussell with a break. She's got Bowman to beat. Lewis Fussell is going to show and go around and underneath the sticks. Well, we mentioned she got a hat trick against Featherstone Rovers last time out against Featherstone, and she's on the score sheet again. Bradford extend their lead. They've hit double figures. It's 10 points to nil, and the crowd in the stand, in the far stand, on the feet, jumping up and down. 14 minutes gone, and that is what Lewis Fussell can do to you. Lagana then meticulously looking at the ball, looking at the post. That one will go between the post and over the black dot, and it is Bradford Bulls 12, Featherstone Rovers 0. 15 minutes gone.
Takes the scores to Bradford Bulls 12, Featherstone 0.
And for all Featherstone's efforts there, just undone by a defensive lapse as Lewis Fussell picked the ball up, the dummy half. She realised the markers of Haley and Marshall, they weren't square, the gap was open. And despite a valiant effort from Kaylee Bowman, the Featherstone Rovers fullback, she just had a little bit too much of a head start to plot her way to the line. So the restart, it's gone out, dead in goal, a goal line dropout coming up here from Featherstone. So Andrea Dobson, she's rolled the dice, she's got a six, and she gets to go again because Featherstone Rovers, they'll get the ball back, and it's the first goal line dropout of the afternoon. And as we've seen it in the men's game, in the amateur game, the junior game, the sides that score, they tend to have that adrenaline still flowing through, and they've just lacked a little bit of focus there, the Bradford Bulls side. And a chance now for Featherstone to get back in this game, trailing by 12 points to nil. It's over on the far stand side with Price, and Price is going to return it 15 out from the Bradford Bulls women's try line. Here we go with Peach in at dummy half, and she's going to have a tilt towards the Bradford Bulls line, and she's brought down now 2 metres shy over on the far stand side as it comes back on the inside to Dobson. Dobson on the angled run, can she reach out and score? The referee has a look, she's about 1 metre shy of the line. Peach along the line finds Field. Grace Field wrapped up by three hungry, suffocating Bradford Bulls defenders. Incessant pressure though on the Bradford line. They're throwing everything at Featherstone. It goes out to Roach. Roach steps in one, steps in two. Roach is underneath the sticks. And Jordia Roach, what an individual try that was. The referee points the finger. Nigel Wood, the RFL chief executive, he's in attendance here. He's applauding that one to our left. And it's game back on here at the Manchester Regional Arena in the inaugural Women's Super League Grand Final. It is Bradford Bulls 12, Featherstone Rovers 4. The kick will come from underneath the sticks.
Rovers
So Georgia Roach converting a road try underneath the sticks. 21 minutes gone here, and it is Bradford Bulls 12, Featherstone Rovers 6. A great individual effort there from the diminutive Georgia Roach, showing tremendous dexterity to evade all those Bradford Bulls defenders. And as we said, Featherstone nothing short of what they deserve. And can they go on and get back in this game and draw level? Out of dummy half it goes from Peach to Field, and Field's broken clear. Field up and over halfway inside the Bradford half, but she's lost the ball with the impact of the tackle, the impact of the collision there from Shoda Hoyle, and the ball's come loose. It will be the zero tackle for the Bradford Bulls, and they're once again coming down this middle channel, and like a wrecking ball, Amy Stavler is going to try and make some metres and get Bradford some much needed momentum. They're almost shell-shocked by that Featherstone Rovers score, but back to come the Bulls. 25 out now from that Featherstone Rovers try line. The Bulls supporters in the far stand making noise as Maroney tries to drop the shoulder and ghost past the Featherstone defence, but she can't. She's 20 out from the Featherstone Rovers line as the pass comes out towards Savannah Andre, the 18-year-old. She's still moving forward, twisting and turning, can't offload the ball in the tackle. And on tackle number four, she's brought down, five out from the line. They're going to try and squeeze in at the corner with Hardcastle. Hardcastle's put the ball down, but it's short of the line. In the act of scoring there, Amy Hardcastle. She's lost the ball, and it will be head and feet to Featherstone Rovers. So Bradford going agonisingly close to getting a third try in this grand final. It instead will be a relieving scrum 10 metres out to Featherstone Rovers, and it will be a huge respite there for Featherstone. Georgia Roach feeds the scrum. Out it comes here from Madison Lawrence. Two women markers in defence. Sarah Dunn. Just a bit of one-man rugby from Featherstone. They've done a lot of work in defence. Bradford 12, Featherstone 6. 22 minutes gone. 18 minutes out from half-time, and it really is a gripping inaugural Women's Super League Grand Final as Featherstone up to the halfway line on tackle number four. They've got one tackle remaining in this set of six. There's options from Peach towards this main stand side. She goes out with Dobson. Dobson floats the ball out to Bullman. Bullman cuts back in, and Bullman's going to look for a mazy run, and Bullman's gone! Bullman's gone! She's going on the angle. Can she get there in time? Because Booth's cut down her path, and Charlotte Booth cuts her down, and now 10 metres out, Bradford defending on their own try line. What an amazing run there it was from Bullman, as Featherstone just a bit of miscommunication then, and that ball's gone to ground with a chance begging. It was the last tackle, it was the power play. They were trying to shift the ball out on this main stand side, and the referee has now got Featherstone inside the 10. So second penalty of the match, penalty apiece, and a chance for Bradford to get some momentum further up the field. Kirsty Maroney would boot to ball, and she finds touch just shy of the halfway line. So if you're just joining us, early tries from Maroney and Fassell, cancelled out by a great effort from Roach, and it's 12-6 in favour of the red, amber and black. So Bradford are going to tap it, their first penalty awarded in this grand final. For Sell down the middle, she's going to go with Hoyle, and Hoyle's dropped the ball. She's going to claim there was two in the tackle, but the referee is going to pack the scrum down, and he will say head and feed to Featherstone. So once again, Featherstone Rovers, great defence. Bit of a carnival atmosphere here at the Manchester Regional Arena. It's situated, of course, on the Etihad campus. It's a superb legacy of the City of Manchester hosting the 2002 Commonwealth Games. It only cost £3.5 million. It is a great facility as Featherstone lose the ball without even getting to tackle number one from the scrum over on that far stand side. And Bradford now are going to have the ball in their possession. going on the edges on tackle number one, although the referee's going to say Bradford have now come up with an error. There's just a light, faint drizzle here, and he'll say the advantage was over because it was a tackle complete and the error coming after the play of the ball. So Bradford now, that's their fourth error in this grand final. So Featherstone certainly much more of a match for the Bradford Bulls this afternoon since their last meeting 13 days ago at the Providence Stadium. Odsell on four from the scrum. Andrea Dobson, she's come up there. An unimposed error. There was no one bearing down on it. Very greasy, very soggy out there, and she slams the ball down into the Manchester Regional Arena turf as if the hoping that the ground would just swallow her up. So it will be a scrum head and feet to Bradford. That's the fifth error of the afternoon by Featherstone. So from the scrum, Fussell's going to be brought down. 10 inside the Featherstone Rovers have. She gets to her feet gingerly, groggily, gets up, plays the ball. And here we go with Hoyle on this right-hand edge, this near side edge. She gets to her feet, she plays the ball. Fussell gives it there to the interchange forward, Danny Swain, and Danny Swain's going to be brought down on around about the Featherstone 30. 10 in from this main stand side. They're going on this short side move. So it goes back to Moroni. Moroni to Fussell. Fussell's caught high around the face, she claims. The referee says shoulder first, so we continue Bradford's assault on this Featherstone Rovers try line. They're 20 metres out now on the fourth tackle. Moroni out of dummy half, gives it there to Hardcastle. She's going to be wrapped up, twisted and turning. She's still going forward. It's a last tackle play here for the Bradford Bulls. Fussell in at dummy half, gives it to Moroni. Moroni kicks it straight down the middle and it's picked up there by Jazz Hassell. And Hardcastle was just claiming there that Featherstone players were getting in her face, but it is rugby league, it's tough, it's physical. And Featherstone throwing everything, including the kitchen sink, including the cutlery drawer, all the spoons at this Bradford Bulls defensive side. And the referee's just going to say the tackle was completed there. As Peach gets to her feet, she'll play the ball. Picked up by Sarah Dunn at dummy half. And now Dunn will reverse roles with Peach as Peach scoops it up, gives it to Field, and Field makes 15 valuable metres forward, and she's brought down 15 shy of the halfway line. Featherstone still inside their own half, but certainly getting a stranglehold on this game, although trailing by 12 points to 6. Emma Sloan is brought down on the fifth and last tackle, turning from this main stand side as Peach, out of dummy half, gives it to Dobson. Dobson, angled kick, just put a little bit too much on that one. The bounce not kind. It goes dead in goal. It will be a seven tackle set from the 20 and a chance for both sides to just get a little breather here because it has been played at breakneck speed and we've got 13 minutes to go to half time. And as we said, the fourth meeting between these two sides, this one is going to be one of the closest you feel after those three blowouts that Bradford have put on Featherstone. Great performance thus far from Featherstone Rovers. Bradford can't unlock the Featherstone defence. Can they find the key on this set? They're 10 shy of the halfway line. Fussell, she does 80 minutes normally. She gives it now to Debbie Smith. Smith on the angled run. She's brought down just on the halfway line. She gets to her feet. She's going to play the ball. Fussell's going to go herself out of dummy half. She's going to go on that short stand side with Lisa Taylor. Taylor beats one, beats two. Can't get past three and four. And she's lost a little bit of ground there as she's marched back. Such is the aggressive nature of this Featherstone Rovers defence. It is with Moroni. Moroni lays it off in the tackle and Hickey's going to be brought down now. And this is tackle number four coming up for the Bradford Bulls. Fussell to Moroni. Moroni kicks towards this main stand touchline. Savannah Andrade is chasing it, but Sarah Dunn to the rescue. Sarah Dunn's lost the ball. Savannah Andrade's going to claim a try there. The referee has a decision to make. Sarah Dunn clearly lost the ball forward, but the touch judge has stood his ground. I don't think this is going to be given. The referee still in consultation with the touch judge. Are they going to say Sarah Dunn was grounded in the in-goal area first? He's looking to make a decision. He's going to rule the try out and he's going to go with what I thought happened. Sarah Dunn tackled in her own in-goal area. ball carrying arm on the ground, and before the ball popped out and was touched down by Savannah Andrade in this corner, and he's going to rule goal line dropout. First goal line dropout of the game. Now the balls have forced Amy Hardcastle. It's gone between the legs. It's going to be picked up by Stavely. Amy Stavely carries it forward, charging like a lioness, and she's brought down 25 out from the Bradford Bulls. Fussell, bullet pass there to Moroni. Moroni along the line to Smith. Smith moving laterally there, and she's now brought down 12 out from the Featherstone line. Bradford hunting for the third try. Here goes Moroni. Moroni kicks through. Savannah Andrade, can she get there? The bounce of the ball just beat her. Savannah Andrade looking for her first try in the grand final, the 18-year-old. And it will be a seven tackle set now for the Featherstone Rovers as the ball is going to be tapped on the 20. This will be the zero tackle, and it is going to be number 11 for Featherstone Rovers, Jazz Azell. And Jazz Azell is brought down in a two-woman tackle, 20 out from the halfway line. So Featherstone really getting back in this game. Bradford Bulls 12, Featherstone Rovers 6. 10 minutes to go to half time here at the Manchester Regional Arena. Out of dummy half, it goes from Peach. Peach gives it there to Sloane. Sloane gets the legs driving forward, and she's five inside Bradford territory. Here we go with Dobson. Dobson to Roach. Roach along the line to Field, and now here goes Field as Grace Field is clattered in a two tackle. They're literally just outside the 20. Here goes Georgia Roach, and Roach is going to be brought down on the fifth and last tackle. 20 out from the Bradford line. It goes to Dobson. Dobson's going to play the percentages, drills it into touch, 10 out. It'll be a scrum, head and feet to Bradford, and with 9.5 minutes to go to half time in this grand final here in Manchester, it is Bradford Bulls 12, Featherstone Rovers 6, and it really is a humdinger. If you're just joining us on the live stream, the live feed, Kirsty Moroni opened the scoring for the Bradford Bulls after just 2 minutes. That was closely followed up by a try from Lewis Fussell, who went 30 metres straight out from dummy half, around and underneath the sticks, and then arguably the try of the grand final from Georgia Roach. She pirouetted away past four Bradford defenders on a zigzag underneath the sticks, converted her own try, and here we are with 9.5 minutes to go to half time. Bradford Bulls 12, Featherstone Rovers 6 in the 2017 Women's Super League Grand Final. So Bradford from the scrum, it's over on the far stand side with Lisa Taylor. Taylor's going to be brought down 10 shy of halfway. As we said, it is grey, it is soggy conditions here. The rain just slightly eased off now, and Bradford looking to play a little bit of an expansive game, but for most of this first half it has been attritional down the middle. They're up and over the halfway line, five inside the Featherstone half. Here goes Fussell. Fussell to Smith. Smith is going to be wrapped up there. Three Featherstone players bringing her down as she gets to her feet, and she will get up and play the ball. Fussell out of dummy half again, caught there on the shoulders by Peach, and Peach drags her down. Great cover tackle. Last tackle, says the referee. It goes to Gardner. Gardner looking to find Taylor on that far stand side. Finds Taylor. Taylor offloads the ball backwards. It's picked up there by Hennigan, but the referee's going to say it's gone forward. And is this going to get the call from the touch judge? That was fifth and last, so it should be just an exchange of ball. The power play extinguished, and Featherstone back in possession, 15 out from their own try line. 85 metres to go between daylight and victory. It's trailing 12 points to 6. Once again, the sun trying to peep behind the clouds here. The floodlights on. And this the appetizer before the main course at Old Trafford later on this evening. Leeds Rhinos against the Castleford Tigers. What a humdinger that's going to be in front of a sold-out crowd of over 73,000. But first, we've got the small man of deciding who is going to be crowned the champions of the Women's Super League. And Featherstone, they're only trailing by 12 points to 6. And they're just shy of the halfway line now as a good tackle comes in from Stacey White. Peach gives it to Dobson. Dobson's going to kick early in the count. Dunn and Marshall are chasing it. Dunn gets a foot to it, hacks it forward, and it's just going to evade Charlotte Booth and going to touch 5 metres out from the Bradford Bulls try line. And Charlotte Booth, she'll say she had that covered, but Sarah Dunn just beat the foot waist there between Hardcastle and Andrade, and she just got a right boot to it, and it's advanced Featherstone 20 metres further. So it's a scrum, head and feed to the Bradford Bulls, 10 out from their own try line. They lead 12-6, and as I was saying earlier, what a great facility the Manchester Regional Arena is. As we said, situated on the Etihad campus, the Etihad Stadium, literally 50 yards to the left, and the arena itself, covered seating for 6,500 spectators. And it really is a multi-purpose stadium with athletics, football and rugby league staged here on a regular occasion. And let's not forget, Manchester Rangers, they've been using this facility since 2015. So they hope one day to have aspirations of joining the rugby league pyramid system and playing potentially in League One. So three tackles gone on this set of six. Bradford moving the ball down the middle. Here goes Moroni, tries to sidestep one, sidestep two, but she's immediately dragged there by Megan Price and dragged down, and she loses a couple of metres. So Bradford goes out there with Forsell. Forsell to Hoyle. Hoyle's wrapped up, and this will be the last tackle. So once again, another good solid defensive set from Featherstone. Bradford on their own 40. Forsell, fly kicks it out of dummy half, and it's just going to find touch 30 out from the Featherstone line on this main stand side. Beth Sutcliffe, Kirsty Moroni were just chasing that, but Sarah Dunn, cool as you like in that grand final environment, just letting that one go into touch. And once again, it'll allow the water carriers to come on and give the girls some much needed refreshment. So the try scorer for Featherstone, Roach, feeds the ball in. It comes out from Peach. Peach is going to kick it forward. It's a foot race between Bullman and Booth. Charlotte Booth's going to get there first, 10 out from her own try line. And she's got Bullman, she's got Dunn to contend with. Booth goes past Dunn, but she can't get past Lawrence and Price. And Lawrence and Price pin her. But this shows you that Featherstone not afraid to mix up the tactics, kicking early from the scrum. As Savannah Andrade lifted there, but not above the horizontal, according to the referee. She'll get to her feet, she'll play the ball. Forsell to Hardcastle. Hardcastle up to halfway for the Bradford Bulls. It's still Bradford 12, Featherstone 6, with 6.5 minutes to go to half time, as Bradford move the ball lateral from left to right over on that left hand edge. 10 metres inside the Featherstone half. Forsell out of dummy half, makes 15 metres forward, and this will be the fifth and last tackle for the Bradford Bulls. 25 out from that Featherstone line. It goes to Moroni. Moroni, though, kicks it forward. The ball went backwards. Sarah Dunn's lost it, but it's gone backwards. And she's swallowed up there by Moroni and Garner. And Dunn gets to her feet, and she'll play the ball with Hazel in there at dummy half. And she takes a big collision there from Hardcastle and Smith. She'll feel that one in the morning. Here goes Bullman at dummy half. Scampering run. Maisie run. Brought down on tackle number three on her own 30-metre line, 20 shy of the halfway line, as it goes back down the middle with Grace Field. But Field is brought down there by Staveley and Sutcliffe in a two-man tackle. Featherstone on their own 40, on the fourth, as it goes to Dobson. Dobson, bullet pass to Sloan. Sloan's going to be brought down on the last tackle, just shy of the halfway line in centre field. Peach gives it to Dobson. Dobson's going to drill this into touch. And once again, Charlotte Booth not going to take a chance with that one. So scrum, head and feet to Bradford. 15 out from their own try line with 5 minutes remaining in this first half. And it's the Bradford Bulls 12, Featherstone Rovers 6. Well, speaking to Bradford Bulls head coach Mark Prescott before the game, he really said that they'd had a really good preparation for this one. Everyone has been training hard. The girls have a good ethos in training, and once you start that winning streak, it can breed and spread itself throughout the team. And he went on to say that victory, should it occur this afternoon, would cap off a fantastic season, and it would be just what the girls deserve. As we said, Bradford coming into this game, 11 wins, no defeats, and we might see the third try of the afternoon here for the Bradford Bulls. Just getting there in the corner is Charlotte Booth, the England international. It was a valiant chase back there by Kayleigh Bowman, and she's gone on as Perla, 60 metres there, skirting down this midstand side, and Charlotte Booth gives Bradford a decisive score. Just minutes before the half-time hooter, 16 points to 6.
Try scoring for Bradford Bulls, number one, Charlotte Booth.
That try from Charlotte Booth befitting the status of a Super League grand final. 37 minutes on the clock. And a chance now for Claire Garner to add an extra two, by far her most difficult assignment this afternoon. Yet to miss. So Claire Garner looks at the ball, looks at the post, draws that imaginary line, but it's just going to fall short. First miss of the afternoon. Bradford Bulls 16, Featherstone Rovers 6. Just watching a replay there of the try from Charlotte Booth, the England international. She was chased back by Dunn and Bowman, but she just had that much head start, too much toe, and it is Bradford Bulls 16, Featherstone Rovers 6, with around about 60 seconds remaining in this first half as the heavens once again open. The referee is telling the girls there's 1 minute remaining in this first half, and what a first half it has been. Certainly we've been treated to some spectacular tries. Nigel Wood certainly enjoying it, the RFL chief executive to our left, and Dobson will get proceedings back underway. It's going to be taken there by Sutcliffe. Sutcliffe gives it there to Staveley, and Staveley's going to be brought down on tackle number one. So Bradford leading by 16 points to 6 in the final seconds of the first half here at the Manchester Regional Arena. Marshall and Peach in defence for Featherstone. Along the line it goes. Debbie Smith, three Featherstone defenders to bring her down on the Bradford 40. Here goes Kirsty Moroney. She palms it back. Alan Gloadstone style. And the ball has come backwards. And here goes Amy Hardcastle. Amy Hardcastle, though, she's going to be brought back. And the referee, the eagle-eyed official, saw that there was a knock-on there by Bradford, and her potential try will not count. And the referee says there's no time for the scrum. He's going to blow the whistle. So half-time here at the Manchester Regional Arena in a gripping Super League Grand Final. It is the Bradford Bulls 16, Featherstone Rovers 6.
second half, Bradford Bulls and Featherstone Rovers.
Well, welcome back here to the start of the second half, the inaugural Women's Super League Grand Final for 2017. Bradford Bulls arriving here, 11 wins, no defeats, looking for the perfect undefeated season. But oh boy, have Featherstone Rovers made life difficult for the Bradford Bulls in that first half. Points to six after tries from Moroni, Fasel and Booth. Roach with the reply for Featherstone, and it will be Bradford to have first use of the ball at the start of this second half. Dobson has it on the halfway line. The rain really coming down, trying not to dampen those supporter spirits who've come here in big numbers, just as they did in the Challenge Cup final at Hewarth. And from the restart, the resumption of play, the Bulls have come up with an error, just like Featherstone did at the start of this game in the first half. And will lightning strike thrice? Can Featherstone get back in this game? They're presented with a huge opportunity, Bradford's fifth error of the match, and they're going to have the ball 15 out from the Bradford line. And now Featherstone have to be careful not to come up with an error themselves, getting a little bit too giddy. They're going to try and calm it down as it goes from Peach to Dobson. Dobson along the line to Haley, and Haley is brought down there in a two-woman tackle there by both Taylor and Wilson. 10 out for Sell, trying to marshal that Bulls defence as it comes back down the middle here with Teach, and she's going to get to her feet. She'll get up and she'll play the ball. Peach to Dobson. Dobson along the line to Roach. Roach still going forward, manages to suck in that defence, gives it back to Peach. Here goes Bell. Bell's going to have a tilt at the line. Jazz Bell still going, and she's finally brought down by Hardcastle, who comes in and drags her by the shoulder, and finished off there by Stacey Wilson. She's going to get to her feet, goes to Peach along the line, and she's going to find her attack extinguished on the fifth and last. Featherstone, an early opportunity here on the last. The kick comes in from Peach. It was a little pepper, one of those that goes along the carpet, and it was picked up there by Claire Garner, and Garner is brought down 10 out from her own try line. Andrade in at dummy half. She's caught on the shoulder, a heady collision. And the referee says it was legal and fair, and that will be a zero tackle. So Bradford have put themselves under more pressure at the start of the second half. Out from dummy half, a marauding, stampeding run from Sloan, and Sloan's eight out from the Bradford line. They're going to look towards their options, and it's going to be Peach to Dobson. Dobson on the angle run. Dobson has had the ball stolen, 2-on-1. The referee is going to say penalty, and that's only the third penalty in this Women's Super League Grand Final. And the referee's going to make Dobson tap the ball on the mark, exactly 5 metres out, parallel with the line. A peep of the whistle, away we go. Back down the middle, it's going to go there with Bell. Bell's wrapped up, although she's lost the ball in the tackle, on tackle number one. And that was Claire Garner and Shona Hoyle wearing 11, the high-fiving each other. And Featherstone, after being presented with two attacking raids, the ball will go back into the grasp of Claire Garner, and she will feed the scrum. Stacey White takes it out. Tackle number one gone. We've had 2.5 minutes gone on a soggy grand final afternoon in Manchester. It's not dampened the spirits of those supporters who've come across the M62 from both Bradford and Featherstone. It's a gripper. 16-6 at half time. It's still 16-6. No change to the second half score as it goes out to Hoyle from dummy half, and the referee's now going to give a penalty to Bradford. So a couple of early penalties to start this second half. It's only the fourth penalty, both of, incidentally, awarded for two
on one in the tackle, a ball steal. So a chance now for Bradford. 10 metres inside that Featherstone Rovers half. Lewis Fussell. Ball in hand. Gives it to Hoyle. Shauna Hoyle fronts it up, takes it in. Courageous, all these players. And she's brought down 25 out from the Featherstone Rovers try line. Stacey Wilson now takes the pass from Fussell out of dummy half. And she turned on her back. It'll give Featherstone an extra second to set up their defensive stall. Out of dummy half, it's going to go down the middle. Here goes Lauren Hickey. And Hickey's going to penetrate the Featherstone Rovers 10. And with two tackles in the bag remaining in this set, Bradford are going to try and unlock this Featherstone Rovers defence on their first real attack, as a laid off pass there from Moroni is going to see Sutcliffe brought down a metre shy of that Featherstone Rovers try line. Fussell out of dummy half to Moroni. Moroni tries to barge her way over, but the diminutive halfback is pushed back in the field of play. It is going to be a last tackle, says the referee. Lewis Fussell looking to grab a brace. Is it going to be double delight for Lewis Fussell? No, it's not. She's held up short. Tremendous goal line defence there from Featherstone Rovers, and the score remains Bradford 16, Featherstone 6. They're trailing by 10. The need to get back in the game. 35 minutes remaining, and Bradford have got Featherstone where they want them, deep inside their own half. There's a good cover tackle comes in there from Stacey Wilson and Lewis Fussell, bringing down Casey Haley. Out of dummy half, it's going to go from Peach. Peach to Teach, as Zoe Teach is wrapped up. Peach once again, forward passes the referee. So Sinead Peach's pass there to Jazz Bell, adjudged to have gone forward. And the referee will pack the scrum down, 20 out from the Featherstone line. So if you're just joining us on the live stream, courtesy of the Rugby Football League, just quickly go through the Bradford Bulls side while the scrums form. Charlotte Booth at fullback, wing free quarterline, Charlene Hennigan, Savannah Andrade, Amy Hardcastle and Lisa Taylor. The halves were Claire Garner and Kirsty Moroney, as Bradford look to move the ball on this left hand side from the scrum. Garner in at dummy half. Booth gets to her feet. She's already scored an absolute pearler, a scintillator in the first half. Here goes Shauna Hoyle now from dummy half. The two 11s meet. Five out underneath the shadow of the Featherstone Rovers sticks. Hoyle gets to her feet. She plays the ball. It goes to Garner. Garner drops the shoulder, and Claire Garner slides over the line. And Bradford have a fourth try at the start of this second half. 7 minutes gone on the clock, and it's now Bradford Bulls 20, Featherstone Rovers 6. Garner there in Bradford's fourth try scorer, complementing the scores in the first half from Moroni, Fussell and Booth, and she will attempt to convert her own score and add on the extra two. Don't forget, coming up after this Super League Grand Final, we have the Championship Grand Final involving Stanley Rangers and Alton. That certainly promises to be just as intoxicating as this one. Claire Garner just to the left hand side of the sticks, waved away by the officials. So with 9 minutes gone at the start of this second half, it's Bradford Bulls 20, Featherstone Rovers 6. So crucially, three scores in front, a difference of 14. Featherstone really have to chase the game now, but whatever happens, their supporters can be really proud of that first half effort where they push Bradford all the way. And I'm almost certain that that energy and enthusiasm level's not going to drop in the final 31 minutes here. Referees just call time off as we wait for the ball to come on the field. So when these two sides met in the Challenge Cup final at Hewarth in York, there was A four-figure crowd, over 1,000 were in attendance that afternoon, and looks to be said there's round about 1,000 here at the Manchester Regional Arena. The growth of the women's game. And from the restart, picked up there by Charlotte Booth, as we said, who scored an absolute scintillating 60-metre effort along this main stand touchline in the first half, and she's brought down just shy of her own 20. Fussell in at dummy half, gives it to Smith. Sorry, that's Hickey. Hickey wrapped up in a two tackle and turned on a side just to delay the play of the ball. Here goes Fussell. This now is Smith, and Smith flattens into the Featherstone Rovers forwards of Teach and Sloan. Fussell to Hoyle. Hoyle grappling. Featherstone Rovers on the halfway line. Garner to Cortman. Jess Cortman sucks in that defence on this main stand side. Back to Fussell. Inside support to Hoyle. Hoyle, expansive play, gives it there to Sutcliffe. Sutcliffe wrestled to the ground on the last tackle. A nice move from the Bradford Bulls women's side. Fussell to Moroni. Moroni's just going to kick towards touch on the far stand side, and he'll run time off the clock. Bradford, of course, have the lead, 20 points to 6. And Featherstone now will try and pack the scrum and call the referee to call time off. As we said, we had a bit of a downpour in the first half. It looks to have eased off at the start of the second. The sun trying to peep out from behind the clouds. The floodlights on at the Manchester Regional Arena. Stanningly against Alton. That one due to kick off at 2 o'clock after the climax of this one. And then, of course, the big one, the Betfred Super League Grand Final at Old Trafford. Sold out at Featherstone. They've come up with a knock-on, two tackles in. Picked up there by Cortman, and Jess Cortman, one of those interchange players for Mark Prescott's side, is wrapped up 20 out from the Featherstone line on the zero tackle. Here goes Fussell. Fussell down the middle with Hickey, and Hickey's going to be brought down 10 shy. Slap bang centre. Sutcliffe now. And Sutcliffe's attacking raid extinguished. The 10 metres out from that Featherstone Rovers try line. Moroni slips, and she's immediately swarmed upon like bees around the honey, and she's wrapped up 5 shy of that Featherstone Rovers half, although the referee has spotted an injury in back play, and he will stop the clock and halt proceedings as Grace Field is allowed to get up and take a place in that Featherstone Rovers defensive stall. So Kirsty Moroni, time back on, will get up, plays the ball. Here we go, back down the middle, as Bradford looking to add a fifth try to their tally. Fussell out of dummy half to Moroni. Moroni looking for a second. Moroni's over the line. The touch judge has stood his ground, and the referee is going to say no try. Kirsty Moroni has dropped the ball over the Featherstone Rovers line in the act of scoring, and it will be a 7 tackle set to Featherstone. So a bit of a respite and a breather for Featherstone. Scoreboard remains 20 points to 6. And it will be a tap on the 20. 28 minutes remaining in this one. Bradford 20, Featherstone 6. Bit of a subdued atmosphere to start the second half. Supporters still coming back from their half-time refreshments. Peach in at dummy half. And the referee's got Bradford for inside the 10. So a fifth penalty in this Women's Super League Grand Final. Featherstone leading the penalty count 3-2. They're not going to kick to touch. It's just going to be tapped there by Peach. And Peach immediately gives it to Bell. And Bell's brought down on the halfway line. Out of dummy half. It goes to Dobson. Bullet pass from Dobson. But it's a knock on there from Kayleigh Bullman. And Bullman, she just had a look at her opposite number, Claire Garner, who was coming into view. And she's come up with Featherstone's sixth error of the match. And it will be a scrum on the halfway line to the Bradford Bulls. So, from the scrum, Garner. Fussell. Booth goes on the angle, strides up, straightens up. 5 inside the Featherstone half. Fussell in at dummy half. to Hardcastle on that right-hand edge. Hardcastle puts a fending on Donna Naimi. Hardcastle's away now. Hardcastle has Bowman to beat. She's going to put a fending on Kayleigh Bowman, and she's done a Jonah Lomu here at the Manchester Regional Arena. That was unstoppable, and Bradford have a fifth try. It's the Bradford Bulls 24, Featherstone Rovers 6. Take a bow, Amy Hardcastle. She went past Marshall, Dunn and Bowman.
Try score for Bradford Bulls, number 4, Amy Hardcastle.
Fifth try of the afternoon then for the Bradford Bulls as they start to put a little bit of daylight between themselves and Featherstone. Claire Garner, 15 metres to the right-hand side of the uprights, back on track, back on target. 3 from 5 attempts this afternoon, and it is Bradford Bulls 26, Featherstone Rovers 6, with 26 minutes remaining. And there'll be no one prouder in that Bradford side than Amy Hardcastle. She's been with the Bradford Bulls women's side since their inception in 2015. And it looks like the perfect season could be about to materialise as a reality here for the Bradford Bulls. As we said, it started in the pre-season. They then went through the Challenge Cup undefeated. They lifted the silverware in York in July in front of a crowd of 1,004, beating Featherstone by 50 points to 16. And then they've gone through the Super League regular rounds undefeated, and here they are in the grand final, looking to emulate many sports, great sporting sides, undefeated in the season. So the restart once again along the floor, picked up there by Charlotte Booth. Booth's going to be brought down on tackle number one. In at dummy half is Fussell. Fussell looks at her options. She's going to find Hickey. Hickey strides forward down the middle, 10 shy of the halfway line. Fussell finds Beth Sutcliffe, and Sutcliffe up to the halfway line. Three tackles gone for the Bulls here. Fussell picks it up, scoops it up, leisurely stroll, tries to unlock the Featherstone edge defence, but she can't. So good sliding defence from Featherstone, and on the fourth tackle she's 2 metres inside the Featherstone half. Moroni in at dummy half, and this will be the fifth and last now for the Bradford Bulls. Just shy of that Featherstone 40, Fussell goes deep on the halfway line from Garner. Garner straight down the throat there of Bowman. Bowman takes it under pressure, and she's going to be trapped. 10 out from her own try line. The referee calls held as Shona Hoyle and Charlene Hennigan were pushing Bowman back towards her own try line. And now Featherstone have lost the ball, but the referee says it's been stolen. 2-on-1. So it's a relieving penalty to Featherstone. They've not really had much territorial possession or pressure apart from that opening period at the start of the second half after the Bradford error on the resumption of play. As we said, this is what the Bradford Bulls women's side do. It's almost like sucking the life out of you. Gets very attritional. But Featherstone not waving that white flag yet. So, from that tap penalty, 20 shy of the halfway line, what could Peach try and do? She gives the ball there to Hazel, and Hazel's going to be brought down just shy of halfway on tackle number two. It goes Peach, misses out Emma Sloan, the ball's gone backwards, and that's tackle number three. Lost a little bit of momentum, a little bit of ground there. Peach out of dummy half, tackle number four gone, still just shy of the halfway line in centre field. Sinead Peach going out of dummy half, brought down there by Wilson and Hoyle. Last tackle, says the referee. It goes to Dobson. Dobson's going to kick to space. Charlotte Booth's going to call for it. Booth takes it. And Booth is brought down a metre inside the field of play. She gets to her feet. She plays the ball. Andrade in at dummy half, the 18-year-old. And she's going to be brought down in a free woman tackle. Five out. So tackle number two for the Bradford Bulls. Got a bit of work to do here. And that's a great mark of defence there from Andrea Dobson. So three tackles gone. Featherstone have got the Bulls where they want them. Jess Corbin there flirting with this main stand touchline before finally going to ground, as Shona Hoyle will make some valuable metres forward. Bradford on their own 30 on the last tackle as the light drizzle once again opens up. Fassell out of dummy half, finds the support from Garner. Garner draws in the winger and it goes out to Charlene Hennigan. Hannigan's wrapped up on the last tackle by Bullman, and Kaylee Bullman there showing great defensive qualities. She went straight there to Charlene Hennigan, who was away after that neat little pass back on the outside from Claire Garner, who had sucked in Sarah Dunn, and Bullman saves the day. Score remains Bradford Bulls 26, Featherstone Rovers 6, with exactly an hour gone on the clock. So one quarter remaining here in the inaugural Women's Super League Grand Final at Manchester Regional Arena here, albeit a very soggy regional arena. Featherstone up to their own 45. Sloan gets to her feet, plays the ball. In at dummy half is going to be Peach. Peach gives it there to Hazel, and Hazel makes up good metres forward. Surging like the crest of a wave here, the Purple Rovers, but a bit of juggling there in at dummy half from Georgia Roach, and she's coughed the ball up, and Bradford have accepted an early gift. Here it goes with Shona Hoyle. Hoyle up to the halfway line, like dodgems at a fairground, crashing into each other. And she's brought down on her knees. She gets to her feet. She's going to play the ball. Booth in at dummy half. Booth tries to make some meters as she scampers for a roundabout, a gain of 10. Just outside the Featherstone 30 as it misses out Moroni, and it's going to find Beth Sutcliffe. As Sutcliffe finds the support from Amy Hardcastle on that right-hand edge. Here goes Hardcastle. She's already scored one try. She's looking for a second, and she's brought down just outside the 20. Hardcastle to the right-hand side of the sticks. It's going to go from Fassell to Moroni. Moroni to Andrade, and Savannah Andrade just couldn't quite catch that passing. It was one of those boomerang passes that sort of give the impression it's going backwards, but it sort of curled forward, caught the wind, and it was just a little bit too much forward there, and it's just got into touch. So once again, respite for Featherstone Rovers, but what a great effort from both sides, it must be said. 18 minutes remaining, Bradford Bulls 26, Featherstone Rovers 6, the fourth meeting between these two West Yorkshire rivals in 2017, and Featherstone making Bradford work every minute for every point. An impromptu PA announcement then. So 18 minutes remain. Can Featherstone get back in this grand final? As we said, what a great victory last weekend. Golden point extra time win against Fatto Heath St Helens, who finished second in the table. So coming up against the indomitable force of the Bradford Bulls. Although the referee here is going to say Bradford guilty of stealing the ball in the tackle once again. So the penalty count now going away from the Bulls. Peach didn't fancy kicking to touch, so she's just going to tap it, and they're going to come on this shorthand side. Jazz Hazel now wearing a blue scrum cap. Gives it there to Jazz Bell, and Bell's brought down on tackle number two. Two-man tackle there from the Bulls, led by Hoyle and Cortman, as they come back down the middle to Rovers. 20 shy of the halfway line. Fassell in at dummy half. So too is White as it goes back down with Grace Field. And Fields on the halfway line for Featherstone Rovers. Appealing for a penalty, not forthcoming. Goes to Dobson. Dobson to Lawrence. Lawrence makes 10 metres inside the Bradford half. So she'll get up and play the ball. 40 out on the last tackle. Roach kicks over the top of Booth and Andre, and it goes into the running track here at the Manchester Regional Arena. That'll be a seven tackle set on the 20. And as we said, soggy conditions here, really attritional. Credit to the girls for putting on such a fantastic spectacle. Some great tries we've seen from both sides. We saw Charlotte Booth just before half time going 60 metres, and prior to that we saw Georgia Roach for Featherstone Rovers on that pirouetting mazy run towards the Bradford line, beating those four Bradford defenders. Bradford leading 26 points to 6, 16 and a half remaining on the countdown clock. Out of dummy half from Fussell to Hoyle. Hoyle Clatton there in a two-woman tackle, 15 out from the halfway line on the third tackle. Here it goes with Cortman to White, and White's going to be ragged down there to the floor as both Salone and Peach in that two cover tackle. Charlotte Booth out of dummy half, just inside the Featherstone half. That'll be tackle number four of this seven tackle set. Gets to her feet, plays the ball. Scooped up pass there from Fussell to Garner. Garner to Cortman. Jess Cortman looks for support, but she can't. She's twisted and turning, and she's wrapped up. And this will be the fifth and last tackle on this set for the Bradford Bulls. And they're 30 metres out from the Featherstone half as Garner, out of dummy half, kicks, looking to find Maroney. Maroney was trying to kick that forward, but Madison Lawrence just dropped on her back and absorbed the ball, and she averted the danger. And Featherstone now can turn defence into attack and potentially try and get some momentum and move up the field. They're still penned inside their own 30. There's some more ruthless, dogged defending from Swain and Sutcliffe. Bring down the Featherstone Rovers prop forward, Emma Sloan. The ball's now being knocked on. Referee's playing the advantage. It will be the free play as Beth Sutcliffe hacks forward. The danger's averted and will come back. It will be a scrum, head and feet to the Bradford Bulls. 40 out from the Featherstone Rovers try line. Featherstone's seventh error of this match. And as we said, the Women's Super League looking to expand in 2018. Leeds Rhinos holding trials this coming week, this coming month, sorry. Certainly looking to expand. And as we said, below the Super League, there is a thriving Championship division. And we are going to see Stanley Rangers against Ulton Raiders. That a 2 o'clock kickoff. And as we said, Bradford, they finished top of the table, so they automatically qualified for the grand final this afternoon. Featherstone needed golden point extra time to see off St Helens. 21-20 last weekend. What a game that would have been to have witnessed. Bradford, though, looking to put the icing on the cake as Charlotte Booth manages to offload the ball in the tackle on the far-stand side to Lisa Taylor, and Taylor's going to be brought down a metre shy of the line. Bradford backing the danger zone. Kenny Loggins would be proud. Five out from the line as it goes for Fussell. Fussell to Maroney. Maroney trying to scamper her way over, and she's a metre shy of the line. Bradford, unstoppable pressure on this Featherstone Rovers line. There's a charge to the line there from Beth Sutcliffe, and she's now held up. Fussell's options to the left, to the right. It's on the last tackle, the power play for the Bulls. They lead 26 points to 6. Charlene Garner. Garner gets it out to Cortman, and Cortman's going to see Charlene Hennigan score. That was an unselfish act there by Jess Cortman. Bradford almost patter cake rugby league, move the ball along the defensive line. Featherstone just ran out of numbers, and Charlene Hennigan has Bradford's sixth try in this Women's Super League Grand Final here at Manchester Regional Arena. And it's now the Bradford Bulls 30, Featherstone Rovers 6. The kick to come from Claire Garner.
Try scorer for Bradford Bulls, number 2, Charlene Hennigan.
Bradford's sixth different try scorer this afternoon. Charlene Hennigan getting in on the act. Also complimenting scores from Maroney, Fussell, Booth, Garner and Hardcastle. And Garner will attempt the conversion attempt. 15 metres to the left-hand side of the uprights. This to add on the extra two. That one just creeps in on that left-hand upright. And it is Bradford Bulls slowly racing away with this one now. It's 32 points to 6. Gianna, 4 from 6 attempts. She's a personal haul of 12 of Bradford's 32 points in this grand final. And with around about 10 minutes remaining, Bradford 32, Featherstone Rovers 6. It's on the horizon now that Bradford are looking like they're going to go undefeated in the 2017 Women's Rugby League season. The restart from Georgia Roach. Taken on the far stand side, and immediately Glatton in that two cover tackle, 15 out from her own try line. Hardcastle picks it up from dummy half. She's still going forward, it's Hardcastle. Brought down by Sloan and Zania. Erica Zania on for the final 10 minutes as it goes back down through Stacey White. Stacey White's going to be wrapped up 15 shy of the halfway line for the Bradford Bulls. Here goes Beth Sutcliffe. Sutcliffe just makes 10 metres forward for Sell now. Laying that attacking platform. Danny Swain goes without the ball. A rare error from Danny Swain, and Featherstone on the zero tackle. They're on the halfway line. The referee looking at Emma Sloan, who's down in back play, and he's just going to stop the clock here, the referee, because Emma Sloan down in back play with what looks like a head injury. The play's just going to be temporarily suspended here. Just quickly go through the two sides. Featherstone Rovers started with Kaylee Bullman at fullback. Wing three quarter line, Sarah Dunn, Rhiannon Marshall, the former Bradford player, Casey Haley and Manina Spur, the halfback pairing of Andrea Dobson and Georgia Roach. The front row forwards, Emma Sloan, Sinead Peach and Joe Teach. And the back rowers of Jazz Hazel, Jazz Bell and Grace Field. And on the interchange bench, Erica Zania, Megan Price and Madison Lawrence. While the Bradford Bulls started with Charlotte Booth at fullback, wing three quarter line of Charlene Hennigan, Savannah Andrade, Amy Hardcastle and Lisa Taylor. The halfback pairing, the England halfbacks, Claire Garner and Kirsty Moroney. The front row forwards of Lauren Hickey, Lewis Fussell and Stacey Wilson. And the back rowers of Shona Hoyle, Amy Staveler and Beth Sutcliffe. And on the interchange bench for Bradford coach Mark Prescott, Danny Swain, Debbie Smith, Stacey White, Hayley Heals, Jess Cortman, Joe Orlandshaw and Emma Hartley. So time back on here at Manchester Regional Arena. The final 9 minutes of the inaugural Women's Super League Grand Final. Watch this event grow as Featherstone look through Dobson. Dobson collides there with Hoyle, and Cortman gets to her feet, plays the ball out of dummy half. It's going to go with Teach, brought down there by White, also Swain, and the referee's going to say ball stolen again. So Featherstone getting a glut of penalties late on in this game. Can they get over that Bradford Bulls line and give their travelling supporters something to cheer? Here goes Peach out of dummy half, along the line to Dobson. Dobson, though, is going to be wrapped up there by some hungry and eager Bradford Bulls women's defence. Peach down the middle. It goes to Bell, and the referee's whistle is going to halt proceedings, and he's going to say Bradford are inside the 10. So Featherstone awarded their 7th penalty of this grand final. More pressure for Bradford to absorb. 5 metres out, it's going to be tapped there by Peach. It goes there to the big prop forward, Jazz Bell, and Bell is brought down by 5 Bradford Bulls defenders. Quick play the ball. Peach to Dobson. Dobson to Roach, and Roach there on the slippery surface, wriggling around like a worm in dirt, somehow gets it out to Dobson as Dobson's bullet pass is going to find Bowman, and Bowman reaches out in the corner for a Featherstone Rovers try, but the referee is going to disallow it. He's going to say Kayleigh Bowman lost the ball in the act of scoring. He got the nod from the touch judge. Featherstone going oh so close at the death here. The score remains Bradford 32, Featherstone 6, and Bradford will tap it on the 20. Job done for the Bulls, they'll say. Great defence, although they've come up with an error on tackle number one now from Stacey White. So the conditions really playing a part with the handling going into the closing stages of this one. 7.5 minutes to go. The referee's just going to stop the clock while Featherstone form it. And Georgia Roach will look at options to try and unlock this Bradford Bulls defence as they come back down the middle. Jazz Hazel with that blue scrum cap gets to her feet, plays the ball. Here goes Oteach on an attacking raid down the middle, down the heart of this Bradford Bulls defence, down that central reservation. Here goes Peach. Peach, Lawrence, and Lawrence is wrapped up on the third. Hoyle coming with White, crucial two cover tackle. She's juggled with it as Field. She sucked in the defence, it's gone backwards. And the referee says it's come off a Bradford hand, so he's waving the tackle count back. Field picks it up at dummy half and now has a tilt at the line. Featherstone throwing everything at this Bradford Bulls defence. Can they cross for their second try? It goes out towards Hazel, and Jazz Hazel is wrapped up over on that left-hand edge, 5 metres out. Bradford, though, defending resilience there. They're not going to let Featherstone score if they can. Over from dummy half goes Peach. Can she try and get the ball down? No, she can't. It's all Featherstone in the final minutes here. Out of dummy half to Dobson. Dobson's dropped the ball. And that, as we said, it is just suffocating Bradford Bulls defence. And Dobson a little bit upset with dropping that after all that pressure. Slams the ball and kicks it away. It'll be a scrum head and feet to the Bradford Bulls. And they still lead 32 points to 6 with 4 minutes remaining in this grand final here at Manchester Regional Arena. Kirstina Morona out from the scrum. Oh, there's a line break here by Charlotte Booth. Booth in pursuit is Bowman. Booth's going to try and go the distance, but Bowman's got her. Bowman brings her down, and Booth, after 50 metres, she's just outside the Featherstone Rovers 30, but Bradford have Featherstone stretched if they can get the ball out wide. It goes to Hardcastle, and she's got the ball. It's come loose in the tackle. The referee's playing on here. Hardcastle, a metre shy of that Featherstone Rovers try line. Featherstone stretched, hanging on for dear life here. Fassell, it goes to Garner. Garner along the line, it's touched a Featherstone hand. That's play on, says the referee, is it? Jess Cortman has ball in hand, tries to touch down in the corner. The referee's going to say first knock on. And he's going to give head and feed to Featherstone Rovers. So Featherstone have kept the line intact, although the touch judge is coming on the far stand side. He's held his flag up, so he's indicating there was foul play. And the referee now has got to call people back, and it's going to be a penalty to Bradford for a shoulder charge. I was watching the play over on this main stand side, so I didn't see what happened in back play, but the referee gives Bradford their third penalty of the afternoon, and with 2.5 minutes remaining, Bradford have a chance to get try number 7. 32 points to 6 the lead. They haven't had it all their own way in this grand final. The first half, for 20 minutes in the middle, it was 12-6 as Featherstone really tried to put a squeeze on Bradford. Fassell then, as she dummied her way over The referee says no. The supporters think she's got there, but she's going to be told to get up and play the ball. Moroni now at dummy half. It goes to Hardcastle. Hardcastle out in the corner. Savannah Andrade, the 18-year-old, has she touched down in the corner? The referee points the finger. Joyous scenes. The Bradford Bulls interchange players. The racing on the field. So too are the support staff. And the Bradford Bulls, this is the moment they know that they are going to go the 2017 season undefeated. And not only that, they're going to lift the inaugural Super League Grand Final trophy. And it will also mean a double. After lifting the Challenge Cup in July, they're going to lift the Super League trophy here in October in Manchester. Savannah Andrade squeezing in at the corner. Great try, great stuff from the Bradford Bulls. And Claire Gardner now will have a chance to convert it from the far stand side, right on that far touchline. So Claire Gardner just looking at the ball, looking at the post. The referee's going to tell her she's got to move it a little bit further back towards the far touchline. It was right in that far corner. Strikes the ball, not got the legs, just dips below the crossbar. So 36 points to 6.
Unsuccessful conversion leads the scores at Bradford 36, Featherstone 6.
Just seconds remaining then. Featherstone, just enough time, says the referee, to get the restart underway. Georgia Roach. It really has been a Herculean effort from these Featherstone Rovers players. And they're going to get a scrum from the restart. Georgia Roach there, catching Amy Hardcastle out of position, and it will be a scrum head and feet to Featherstone. So perhaps one last hurrah. The referee says a minute remaining. So they're going to have a full set, 20 out from the Bradford line. A chance here to get a try, make the scoreline a little bit respectable, but whatever happens, they've certainly played their part in a great Super League final. Dobson floats the ball out over on this main stand side. Featherstone with Kayleigh Bullman. She steps in, can't get past Hoyle. Hoyle brings her down, 12 out from that Bradford Bulls try line. Fussell in at dummy half to Dobson. Dobson tries to show and go, juggles with the ball, lays it off there to Sinead Peach. Peach is held up on top of the Bradford line, but the referee is going to say Sinead Peach was caught high, and Peach is trying to go for a quick tap. The referee gives the penalty mark, penalty count now, 8-3. It's going to be tapped by Peach. Here goes Grace Field. She's a big lass. Can she get over? No, she can't. It goes out to Dobson. Dobson, a short pass. The ball's been lost on the try line. Charlotte Booth kicks it dead. All eyes on the referee. He puts whistle to lips. The Bradford Bulls, they've done the Challenge Cup and Super League double. They're the inaugural winners of the 2017 Super League Grand Final. And look what it means. 11 games undefeated. The perfect season for Mark Prescott and the Bradford Bulls. Featherstone Rovers players there in a huddle. They can certainly take great pride from what's been a great performance in this final here at Manchester Regional Arena. We're going to have the trophy presentation coming up shortly. But a great final, great spirit. Bradford Bulls started the season with an away victory against Fatto Hise Tellens. And to put things into perspective, when they started the season, when the Bradford Bulls beat Fatto Hise way back in round number one, Fatto Hise up to that point had gone undefeated for 18 months. So the Bradford Bulls then bringing much needed cheer to the club. The players there just shaking hands, exchanging pleasantries. Great spirit, great to see here.
Thank you.
you from the Rugby Football League for your support today. Women's Super League will be back in 2018 bigger and even better. We remind you that today's championship final is still to take place, so stay around for Stanley versus Oldham Rovers.